approve the order of business. No additional deliberation. Motion to approve the agenda. Second. All favor, please say aye. If aye, may I motion carry? This is July 7, minutes are in hand, call for directly to conflict of interest. CNN, motion to reconsideration are in hand, motion to rescission none. Our consideration of toward business none, notices of table matter none. Correspondence submissions to delegations and correspondence.
Mr. Chair, we have in regards to item 1211, funding request, the Link Performing Arts Center. We have an in-camera, in-private handout, which has been circulated to the members.
Thank you. Any petition? Information brought forward. There are none. Reports. 12.11, funding request, the Link Performing Arts Center. Can I have a motion?
Halifax Regional Council approved the provision of a one-time contribution to the Link Performing Arts Society for capital costs related to the Lincoln Performing Arts Center, purpose-built facility in the former World Trade and Convention Center, 1800 Argo Street, not to exceed 10% of the overall capital project cost, to a maximum of $1 million, subject to the terms set out in Table 2 of the discussion section of the staff report dated November 21st, 2018, with funding to come from Q421, the contingency, general contingency reserve. That's so
moved. Any discussion?
I think this is the timing of this is appropriate that we move it on to regional council for a full discussion. There will be many comments about the current situation that we find ourselves in with the budget looking at the next 2 years. We have a number of requests, and it does deserve to have broader discussion at full council.
Okay. Any further discussion? Very quick question. All favor, keep saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. 12.2, the winter funding for snow removal program for seniors.
$600,000 of funding to be found through operating efficiencies within transportation and public works,
the YMCA. So if we can go to 12.14, the Hospital Society of Greater Halifax, could I have some of those motions as well? Counselor Craig?
I see everybody's jumping at all of these today. Take a look at our financial implications of all four reports before us at the same. Yes, sir. So it is moved that the Audit and Finance Standing Committee recommend that Halifax Regional Council, one, approve the provision of a one-time capital grant for to the Hospital Society of Greater Halifax in the amount of $500,000 toward the construction of a residential hospice facility at 618 Franklin Street, Halifax, to be funded as an unbudgeted withdrawal from the General Contingency Reserve, Q421. And two, authorize the Chief Administrative Officer or the designate to negotiate, enter into, and execute a contribution agreement on behalf of the municipality of the Hospital Society of Greater Halifax, including the terms and conditions outlined in Table 1 of the staff report dated October 9, 2018, and otherwise acceptable to the Chief Administrative Officer. I so move.
Do we have a second? I will second that. Get it on the board.
Chair
can
second.
Yeah, Chair can second.
So get it on the board. Roll for discussion.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. I will try this as best I can with a limited voice. I will not be supporting this because, as indicated in my comments to Regional Council, I feel very, very strongly this, is with, with both sides of their mandate, and I will not be supporting. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. This council has continuously put out the boundaries of what is in our mandate and has made significant decisions on behalf of our citizens. And we are moving towards that. In this particular case here, all of these here today, I would like to forward to Regional Council to have a complete discussion at Council level. I do believe that it is that important that we do that. Again, we are reaching a point that over the next 2 years, we'll be deciding by the 1st of April, thereabouts, 2019, really what the financial capacity of this council will be over the next 2 years and what the administration will be able to deliver on. I do believe that this and the others deserve to have a full discussion at Regional Council. I would vote in favor of this, and that's why I would support and ask that my colleagues do the same.
Great for the question.
Question.
All in favor of saying aye?
Aye.
Question mark your name? Motion carried.
Move that the Audit and Finance Standing Committee recommend that intersection of South Park and Central Street in Halifax. For consideration of the 2019-2020 budget deliberations during the budget adjustment list, ALU, and two, subject to council's decision as applicable, authorizing the chief administrative officer to negotiate, enter into, and execute a contribution agreement on behalf of the municipality with the YMCA of Greater Halifax, based on the terms and conditions outlined in Table 1 of the staff report dated June 18, 2018, and so forth.
Any discussion?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Perhaps we could get a comment from one of our staff members. With respect to the changes that were made regarding the height, and what was the intent behind that with respect to the wide and that width and the rationale?
I was impressed with the portion. I was impressed at the approval meeting. But my understanding from the minutes is that the concessions awarded by council were to enable this particular construction. Now it couldn't be separated out of the larger densification and commercial residential development with the development partner. So it was very clear that council's consideration of those development concessions were linked inextricably to this Y being built. They were not independent of the Y.
Okay. But it was like the height nearly doubled. It came close to doubling.
Yes.
So what benefit did that defer on the Y in helping with their approach?
These concessions provided by council for the development agreement increased the value of the Wise property significantly.
And was it, did I read correctly, it was a $22 million increase?
In the value of the Wise land? No. By my calculations, if I use the assessed value and the value for which they sold their property to the developer, I would say it roughly doubled the value of their land.
Okay, back in the regional council on the 20th of March, 2012, it said the mixed-use development provided a $22 million Class C recreation center, no cost insurance, capital operating budget.
Correct.
Okay, so that's the $22 million that we're discussing there. That's the value of the property, of the project, the Y?
That was the projected cost of building the Y at that time.
And it says that no cost to HRM.
Correct. That was recorded in the minutes of that council meeting.
But now this cost to HRM. And my concern, I don't support this, not that I don't support the Y, but we have our own recreation facilities. I know a number of community groups or communities or whatever could use this money for their own recreation purposes. I'm concerned about the statement that they, it's all inclusive, and I had that written down, where all can have the ability to use the facility, and it says guarantees access for all. So what does guarantees access for all mean?
Mr. Chair, my understanding is the YMCA has well-established assistance program for non-members. So they take those by referrals from service providers or self-identified individuals. And those individuals can request assistance either with a membership fee or with a program fee.
But the membership fee is, I don't know what the membership fee is, even 50%, they may be too much for somebody. That doesn't guarantee access at all. That guarantees access for a reduced membership fee. Guarantees access to all means anyone who wants to participate can participate. And it's noted all kinds of abilities, facility, guarantees access for all. It's quite clear in there. And I don't believe that access will be guaranteed for all. Because if it was, it would mean free use of the facility. And free is not mentioned here. A C
That's the latest information that we've received from the Y.
Okay, and I'd like to get this, when it comes to council, perhaps the folks in the Y can help explain how they get, how they plan to get to that, given that I think the maximum they've had between 2014 was 1,700 members. So they're in effect over tripling their membership, and I'm not sure how they're going to do that. But I'd just like to have those information available for when this comes to council.
Mr. Chair, we could request that response in writing so that all the council would have that information at the same time.
Councilor Beckel?
So in that regard, because this is an audit finance to go to regional council, so the conversation will continue. So any of the alternatives in the staff report is to be considered at the council, because number two is where I was sort of leaning towards getting a supplementary report so we would have all that information. And because I know that other, I spoke with other colleagues as well from council, and you know, any investment in recreation that has been done with other groups, like sort of the, with the school board or anything like that, has gone into a joint use agreement, and therefore there is no joint use agreement in this. It's also so that we can see under the guise of recreation our return on the investment that we have for $1 million. So when it goes to regional council, I'm hoping that that, you know, like a supplementary report could be had to sort of see how we are working and on a continual basis from year to year for the investment. I mean, it's just capital, but that's the same. We've done it in high schools and at Cole Harbor District High, Eastern Passage, and our recreation people who work in that regard with, you know, how the services and your guaranteed access is sort of rolled out from year to year. So I'll support this proposal to regional council. I hope that conversation continues.
Councilor Craig?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. This I sometimes struggle with which hat I'm wearing. The hat I'm wearing at this table has to do with the mandate of the committee, that is, do we have the money or not. The merits of any particular program, I think, are for the review of the regional council. Now, if that applies here, it also applies, in my opinion, my humble opinion, process. Those are, you know, we have the numbers, we have the ability to fund this as through the savings. And the other, Councillor Adams and others, I agree wholeheartedly. Preface my remarks at the beginning here. This council, the previous council, have looked at and determined some things are within our mandate, or we're going to stretch that mandate to provide to do some other things in the community. The questions around whether we have enough facilities and the performing building, for example, the cultural center Paris, that's being looked at out in Council budget. We have $5 million projected in the budget, capital budgets for the future that may or may not put something here. So all those types of questions I think are appropriate for regional council. Do we have the money? We have the money to do this. Yeah, that's the hat I'm wearing today. So in my approval or my vote for or against the motion has to do with whether I think it's reasonable financially if we can do this, not the merits of the other things. And, I guess I've said my piece. Thank you.
Ready for the question?
Oh.
Jeff?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Councilor Craig. I'm going to support this going to a regional council as well for full council consideration. I'm also going to bring a proposed motion of reconsideration on the hospice one after this vote here, so that those of us that may have been a little late getting to the table could have a vote on that one. So I'll support this going to council.
Councilor
Kirsten?
So thank you very much. It's nice to hear you talk softly.
I know.
So I shouldn't be talking, but you know, it's okay to have a conversation and listen to a colleague that 90% of the time you agree with, but there's only room for that 10%. I totally disagree. That's why we're going to have discussion at regional council through the budget process. I think the merits of why a project should move forward. That's it. This is just my opinion. I said it very respectfully. So, and my issue, as it was discussed in regional council, I'm certainly supporting this subject. I'm off subject here, but the conversation came around again why a project should move forward. On the hospice piece, council is interpreting it to be under the community health piece. And I understand that, if that's your definition. But as I said, the regional council, I looked up and spent 1 hour looking up what community health means by definition on the internet. And as municipalities are concerned, it generally refers to active transportation, outdoor activities, the things that we can do within a municipality, but not health services. And I know I'm on subject, but I just have to speak there.
Ready for the question? All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Nay. Motion carried. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. If there's a seconder for this, I'd like to move a motion for reconsideration on 12.1.4 of the hospice motion. Change, it really should be with respect to the funding source. I do note, though, that the recommendation for staff is now a one-time capital grant, which would require, if that is your desire to push forward, require a two-thirds vote at council when it gets there, in terms of moving it from 3 years funding to a single one-time capital.
So, can I have a second for the further discussion on the motion of reconsideration?
So just one more. What are the implications of reconsideration?
The motion to recommend, which is on page 2, revision of the capital grant was defeated, and therefore, arguably, that we have a disconnect in the sense that this committee is not recommending a funding source and is not recommended to go forward, although the council has already made a decision to do that. So I think in order to sort of solve that issue, realistically, you should go forward with the request the council has made, which is identify the funding source. But failing which, council has made a direction, so it would like to then come back in the budget process. Council's motion on the front page was to approve the funding and request a staff report to audit finance to identify the funding source and to consider the updated financials.
Yeah.
Right. So essentially, the do nothing option doesn't really stop this, but it does leave council with a lack of information with respect to the funding source.
So, first of all, for clarification, the notice of reconsideration don't have an NCRD order, one in front of the job I trust you do. I do believe that that must, like is being proposed, be presented at respectfully, I'm not going to support. I can't in clear conscience vote against something the regional council, the member of the committee, and say, well, yeah, the funds are there, so I'll support it. So my argument is still the same, regardless of which way you have to muster. I don't support this moving forward. Inevitably, this will go back to council. It would be my guess if this motion for reconsideration is defeated, council will make the intervention. But I'm not prepared to support this financially. So I think that's pretty simple. I mean, we don't come to a standing committee and say, well, I'm not for something, but I better vote for it so I make my council colleagues happy. It's not the way it works.
Thank you. I appreciate what Councilor Carlson is saying. And this is it's an unbudgeted withdrawal. This, along with the two other items, are all unbudgeted withdrawals of $2.5 million. So if the motion were to be amended that the provision of one-time capital grant, the amount of $500,000 goes towards the construction of the residential facility, be funded through a tax increase. Would that be in order? Approve whatever corresponding tax increase of $500,000.
A tax increase in 1920, I think this committee, if it wishes, could make that recommendation to council, and then it would get the council to consider in the overall budget, yes.
Yes.
The challenge.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, and thank you, colleagues. I think what I'm trying to accomplish here is exactly what Councilor Carson says we shouldn't be doing here, which is sending back to council for all of council's consideration, regardless of how you feel at this stage. So you could be a yay or a nay right now, but you just want your council colleagues to have a say, and I think that's okay, in my opinion. Yeah. Actually, I think he said the exact opposite. He said that he won't support it because he's already against it, doesn't want his colleagues to have a say on it. So I'm saying, let's send it back for him. So my point is, whether you're for or against it, you can still send it back for all our colleagues to have a say on it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. My simple view is that council's already said to this. So they already made the motion that we're going to do it and looking at, and then they asked this committee how we're funded. So that's my starting point. And again, within this committee, we bring back to council with a suggestion as to how to fund it. We just can't let it die here because council is going to bring it up again. And the timing of this is such that let's get back to council with the full budget discussion. If we leave it so that we're looking how to fund the $250,000 this year, contingency, and next year through general revenues or contingencies, whatever the reserves, whatever it is, the fact of the matter is it still has to go back to council. Because that's what we would share still doing. So we can't just do nothing with it.
Councilor Adams?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I understand what Councilor Craig is saying, but if we disagree that should be the source of funding, then a no vote would say we disagree. We don't necessarily disagree at this point in time with the funding, but we disagree from this at the source. Regardless of what we do, it's my understanding that this motion will go to council, whether it's 6-0 or 0-6.
And so it won't go to council. Why it's here in the paper, but
unless the motion for reconsideration passes.
Well, it's not.
So it was defeated.
Yeah, it's defeated. Ready for the question on reconsideration. Councilor Carson.
This was mine. I've never seen a motion completely and entirely die in committee. I have to question that wouldn't it at least go back to council without a recommendation at all, with an overview from the clerk's office as to what happened in committee? Because I've never seen it done before.
In some way, it would have to go back to council.
That's exactly
right. Effectively, it'll either have to get dealt with in the budget or staff will have to provide a cover sheet that effectively says the committee's made no decision on this.
That's exactly correct. So the notion that it just dies here is totally something.
The recommendation on the floor having failed dies here. But the matter itself still is going to have to get dealt with.
But that's not my point. But at that point, the council can revisit where they don't put a budgetary part of it. That's exactly what would happen.
I expect the CAO.
Technically speaking, council could send it back here 3 times, and this committee could be defeated 10 times, and still we can go here. So,